guys. We got my 2017 Mustang GT premium package here. And yeah, I've owned it for about almost 1 year. And I put about 10,000 miles on it. So yeah, I'm just gonna review it. And I'll also give you guys like a 10,000 mile update on how's the car been. So let's get started. All right, so let me start off with what I have done to the car so far. So yeah, obviously it is a 5.0. So far, folder intake, JLT. Got a oil catch can here. That's pretty good investment for you guys if you guys have any type of car, really. It's very good. It just catches the oil before it goes into your intake manifold. So long term wise, it's gonna be a very good investment. So yeah, intake, then the American Racing long tube headers.
Let's see if we can get that in there.
Kind of point down there, you can probably see it, the badge.
Well, you can see the badge, but oh, there she is. All right.
So hold yeah, they're 1 7/8 long tube headers, no cats, so the off-road setup. And then yeah, also have a Roush axle back on it as well. So yeah, Roush axle backs, X-pipe as well, and then the American Racing headers. A couple things that I've done to the exterior so far: tinted the headlights, tinted the fog lights, and blacked out the emblem. So basically everything in the front is blacked out. We also got my tail lights blacked out. And yeah, if you guys don't know, on the GTs, so your intake, the way it basically catches air is it's through here. So this connects through here, right there. And then it basically gives the intake air through there. And so yeah, 20 inch rims, I blacked them out. Yeah, I think they're 4 pistons in the front. And then I don't even know what we have in the back. Like, what is that? Come on, Ford, at least put like 2 piston Red Bulls.
Damn, son.
Yeah, blacked out the tail lights as well. And yeah,
bolstering.
I don't know. I think they could do better, to be honest.
Yeah, and the back seat is very small. I mean, I don't even know if you want to go back there, but
honestly, I don't. But I mean, you know,
you can tell.
As you can tell, there's like no like, look at that, nothing.
So yeah, owning it for about 10,000 miles. Whenever you sit on these seats, they kind of leave like your butt imprint in there. Whenever you get out, as you can see, it's kind of like a little hole right there.
Spent too much time on that.
Like only wear and tear that's happened so far in this car. Other than that, I mean, you guys can see the interior is in pretty good condition. So let's go over the features. So down here you got 4 toggles. So your first one to your right is gonna be your modes. Awesome. And it's gonna be your modes. And if you click that, it's gonna give you your modes. So normal, sport plus, track mode, snow and wet. And then the one right next to it, your steering modes. So you got normal, sport, comfort, and yeah, the one right next to it is just traction off, and then the one is just your hazards. So yeah, as I said previously, you don't get these switches in the base GT. You only get these in the premium GT, and then yeah, heated and cooled seats. You also got your track apps and stuff. So if you click left right here, you got your gauge modes, which just tells you all your temperatures and stuff. And you got track apps, so you got your acceleration timers, so 0 to 30, 0 to 60, 0 to 100, quarter mile, 8 mile, brake performance, so stopping power. You also got line lock, you got lap times, and then you can review your results right there. And then, yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the screen. Got climate. I'm gonna go over that. But yeah, that's your screen. You got Bluetooth and all the other goodies. You can connect your phone. You got Apple CarPlay. Yeah.
I mean, I'm 2. There's plenty. Look, I can stretch my legs all the way, and I think the seat might be. Seat's all the way back, but I mean, it's still comfortable, right? I mean, it's not like anybody goes back there, right?
Yeah.
So
we have our seats all the way back, so I mean, we have pretty good leg room and
yeah,
overall good room. But I don't even think this car needs a backseat, but
true.
I mean, it's good to just have it in case, just in case, you never know.
Let me take you guys for a spin so you guys can hear the headers and the way this the car sounds with the setup I have on it.
I'm hauling ass.
But yeah, sounds pretty good. So yeah, let's go for a drive, shall we? It's gonna start off in normal mode.
I think we should, son.
Track mode.
Ready? I mean, it is quiet, but then again, you got the windows up and you're not blowing it, so. Like, it's loud when it wants to be, all right, is what I'm saying.
See, that's what I like about it. But, yeah, I've owned it for about almost a year. And, yeah, driving it every day, it's a very good daily driver. I daily drive it to school and work.
Damn.
So, yeah, it's pretty good. Gives decent gas mileage. And, yeah, it's fast car, so whenever I want to have fun, I can have fun. So yeah, throughout the duration that I've owned it, I haven't ran into any problems with it. As you guys know, it's tuned, as intake as well, and headers. So yeah, I haven't ran into any problems so far. I did get a check engine light, but that was because we did long tube headers and no CATs, so the O2 sensor is one of them. Kind of went off, so we just had to fix that.
That's gone.
Yeah, that's gone. But yeah, other than that, no problems whatsoever. And yeah, it's been a very good daily driver. So, and for the price and the power that you're getting, I don't really think there's much that's out there that can beat it.
All right, guys. Fine. Hope you guys enjoyed that 10,000 mile review and review of my car. If you guys have any video ideas, just put them down in the comments below. We would love to, fulfill what type of videos you guys want to see. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, we'll be dropping more content soon for you guys. Peace.